All right, Coach, you made an interesting comment in there. When we hosted a regional, we probably weren't ready. That was kind of an interesting little nugget.
Yeah, we were young. We had two freshmen that led us out on the weekend on the mound. And, you know, as much as you try to fill them in on what's coming, that lived experience is just different. And, you know, we kind of overachieved, we felt like. We felt like that was going to be the next year, just in projecting out. And we got there, fortunately, a little bit early, but I think, you know, we just weren't quite ready for the experience. But the experience of going through that really, I think, helped us out, you know, last year. But we had some struggles, you know, getting everybody moving in the right direction. We had a lot of injuries. And we weathered the storm, and we knew what we were getting into going into the postseason. And I think that experience the previous year helped us make a run.
Has what basketball done kind of spurred you on a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, what basketball did was amazing. And I think that for us at Loyola, the way they did it is the blueprint. They had guys that came in as freshmen that contributed a lot and were really good players. But by the time they're juniors and seniors, they were great players. And that's the road we're on. You know, the first recruiting class is now their upperclassmen. Our number one pitcher, Steven Still, started as a freshman on the mound and went through those growing pains and has matured both physically and emotionally, mentally. And so now we're at that point where we feel like, you know, it's time to really see if we can make a run at a national championship.
We hear so much about player development. What, you know, I'm trying to get a handle on exactly what that is. I think I know what it is, but the parameters of making that happen, how do you make that happen, Coach?
Well, we're constantly trying to get guys to maximize their individual potential, and that's a moving target if we're doing our job, if they're getting better year to year. And there's a lot of different things that go into that. Nowadays, there's a lot of technology involved, but I think some of the time-tested methods still ring true. You know, the experience that you get on the field, in my opinion, supersedes everything. And so, you know, that's the weight room's a big part of it, the physical maturity. When a guy's playing a lot, as some of those guys were able to do as freshmen, physically they're in a different space by their junior year. Mm-hmm. They've become men. And so, you know, that's a big part of it. But just getting the opportunity to compete and understanding, you know, the mental side of the game and the emotional ups and downs are going to take place especially in a postseason run. Understanding the length of a season, I think all those things, and getting guys to just buying in to be a professional on a day in and day out basis, doing the work that they have to do to maintain their health. And sometimes when guys come out of high school, they don't appreciate that because they were the best player on their team. But, you know, after some time in college, they understand, like, there's work you got to put in to maintain what we're trying to do.
Seems like at times you can be brutally honest with them. Is that?
Well, I think you have to be. But you have to earn their respect through the way that you communicate with them. They have to know that you have their best interests. As long as they know that, I think they want to hear the truth. That's been my experience. And the only way to really grow is to know exactly where you're at. You know, if you have a problem, you've got to recognize that you have a problem before you can fix it. And so those are the communications that we have when we have those individual meetings about this is where you're at, this is where we think you can get to, and these are the steps that you're going to have to take in order to get there. And then it becomes an individual decision. How much individual responsibility are they willing to take? And, you know, we give two guys the same plan, one takes responsibility for it, the other doesn't, they're going to get two massively different results. And so, you know, that individual responsibility is another key pillar for what we're trying to instill in the guys.